Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm going to show you how to deploy the multimodal chatbot that we created yesterday, basically, or days ago. You remember you are following the channel. We created a multimodal chatbot with Gemini Pro 1.5 and Streamlit, and then we make it work in local, and then we will do some tests. Passing some files with an interface, and we were interacting in a mode of conversational chatbot with Gemini Pro, and then asking question about the content of the documents, to do some summarization of the content of the documents, and so on and so forth. Today, what we are gonna do is to deploy this into Google APP Engine, a technology that a serverless technology that is available in Google, something similar to others that also had in other cloud providers like Azure APP Engine as well, or AWS Lambda, or which allow you to quickly deploy our applications and serve the applications into internet, and then they make the application available, and then somehow allow the developers, the machine learning engineers, to don't care too much about the infrastructure and the how to scale, secure and lock all the applications, all the infrastructure, all the stuff that you need to do to deploy an application into a production environment. This again allows you to quickly deploy an application, which the only thing that you need to ensure is the application is working locally, and well, they had a front, you had understand exactly the workflow, how you are going to or the user is going to interact with the model in this case, and the only thing that you need to do is deploy it. And the rest is managed from, in this case, Google. And then they will care about deploying the files into the container, scale case that is necessary, the service to attend a demand. You can do a lot of things. Well, they design this technology just to again quickly deploy applications into the cloud and make them available for users, and don't care too much about the details of the infrastructure, because everything is managed by Google. Obviously, it's a service, pay as you go, and then as much as you consume, you can scale the service, the service of the infrastructure in this case, horizontally and vertically up to some level. Usually there are not GPUs available, so this is probably not oriented to deploy models for inference. There is other services in the cloud providers, Google or in Azure or in AWS, that are there. They are designed for that, like a computer engine in this case, or exactly computer engine in this case, or Kubernetes engine, which are designed to well, to serve applications which they had some more complex requirements in terms of infrastructure. This is a service again to deploy. In this case, you will see is a light application, is a light front. This that allow us to interact with a model, which is also being served. In this case, Gemini Pro is being served by Google. And then we had just watch the video that I uploaded yesterday. You remember we had an access via service account, and then on the application is using this to authenticate against the Vertex AI in this case, and then on, but everything working in this case inside Google. But Similarly, you can have other configurations where this application instead to connect to Vertex AI and work with Gemini Pro is working with Claude 3 in Anthropics, or is working with a model in Azure even, or a model in AWS. If you have the right credentials, it's going to be the same. And also with OpenAI, obviously. Okay, let's go. So we can do the same for free. In just it has a small detail. You can do the same, this deploy. You can create an account in Streamlit and you can do it for free. But, well, the problem with that, this is not something that you can do, how to say, for production in a company. It's something that they provide this feature in Streamlit just to share with the community, and then it's gonna be a professional application. This is not suitable, but if you want to do a try, I did it. It's working very well, and you can also deploy your Streamlit application into the infrastructure of the Streamlit IO and start testing there if you don't want to do it here in Google Cloud, because obviously you have to pay for that. Remember that if you just join to Google Cloud, you have to pay $300. Every cloud provider is doing the same. They give you some credit. I don't have that credit long ago. I finished it years ago, basically, and then on, well, but if you join recently to, or you just joined to Google, you will see that you are able to get a credit to use the services in Google, $300 in this case, if I not remember wrong. In other cases are really similar, the amount of they give you as well some credits. Okay, so App Engine, as I said, is a serverless technology which allows you to deploy applications, web applications, and then you can use the language that you prefer. In this case, it's allowed to use Node.js, Java, Ruby, C#, Go, Python, or PHP, and also allow you to create custom runtimes or custom containers, and then which you need in case that you need a specific configuration that is not covered by the templates that they have in App Engine. So to install this, to activate it, let me check where I have it setting up exactly. The first thing, I suppose that you have your Google account, you need to create a project. If you don't have a project, by the way, you can have multiple projects in your dashboard, so it's a matter of just select which one you have. In my case, I only had one, while my user is accessing to multiple accounts, but this is another story. In your case, if you are just beginning with that, you just created a project just when if you were interacting with Vertex AI, you need to create a project. You can use the same. So this, if you already have it, you can move to the next step, which is to, in this case, create the App Engine, App service application. No, you create a root application which can contain multiple services. You can see here, if I'm not wrong, let me show you. Exactly. You have here, you are creating here with that command, with gcloud app create, you create this application. And the application may have multiple services with multiple versions, and every service can have a different runtime. Meaning that you can have a service in Python, another service in C#. This is up to you, or as I said, custom service. This is giving you a flavor here. Exactly. You have different runtimes, Go, Java, well, all that I explained, and custom runtimes. This, again, allow you to just provide a Docker file, and in the process of deploying the application, instead to go install and retrieve a a Docker image with everything ready to run Go, Java, Node, or .NET, or Python. It will install or create an image according to what you configure in your Docker in your Docker file. Okay, let's start with the project. So I prepare. I just extend the project. I upload yesterday with the multimodal chatbot. You had the videos on the channel, and the first thing that we need to do is take the code and create a repository. Here is a repository Gemini bot, and the only thing that you need to add I create this repository in GitHub as well. Well, the only two files that you need to create is the requirements TST, where you, in this case, as we are using Python, you will include the file, the libraries that we need to run this code, the main and everything, all the dependencies, library dependencies that you have here. We have Streamlit, the client to access Vertex AI, Pandas and NumPy. They are not necessary, but I just included, and Python.NET, this really no needed, we don't use it, but well, I include just in case, because I probably will use it in the next extension of this. I'm pretending also to use a vector database to provide some context to the bot in order to make the answers more accurate, no? Looking at some examples, or when we are retrieving information from documents, give some examples of how the information had to be extracted from the document, to prepare the scenario. Then all these documents will be saved in a vector store, files or Chroma, something that we can create locally on the container. And well, we could also use Pinecone or something like that, but well, for this test we will probably use Face, no, which is good for semantic search. Okay, so you create your requirements txt, and also you create the app yaml. The app yaml is the file that App Engine will use to create your service. We are saying here that we want a Python runtime, so you can specify here, as you said, any of these languages except custom runtime. If you specify custom runtime, you have a Docker file. You need to have a Docker file in your root. So you take environment flexible. This is exactly what you saw in the preview in the web page I showed you just now. The entry point of your application, which command is the application need to execute. This is because at the end, what it's doing is taking an image. You will see now from the Google container repository, an image in this case is going to be Ubuntu 22, and it will have Python 3.11, and in there it will install your application, and then on as a Docker file, you probably see it's exactly doing this, no? It's creating an entry point, and if you create the YAML file, what it's gonna do is just take an image from GRC, is a Google repository. I don't remember what means the C, but it's a Google repository, no, Google container repository, and then here is taking this image. If we specify Python there, it's doing exactly the same, no? And at the end, in a Docker file, you expose an application, or you run you expose an application, expose a port, expose an application, and run something which is working inside the Docker. No, it can be FastAPI, it can be a Jupyter Notebook, a Jupyter server, it can be in this case a straight lead running in the port. In this case, 8080. Why 8080? Because 8080 used to be the reverse proxy port, and this way is open it to internet for everybody. We will have a firewall in front of this port. This is automatically deployed. That's why I say that everything regarding infrastructure, APP engine will take care of. You just need to worry about your application working in the language that you choose. And in this case, as I said, you just here write the endpoint. You just need to worry of this small configuration in order to make this happen. There is more parameters than what you see here, but this is the minimum to we run the application correctly. So we say that in Python we want this running in Ubuntu 22 and with Python 3.11, and this is something to tell the APP engine that use session affinity. What is session affinity? Essentially that Git track of who is sending what, no? In order to also send back, or say send to the client, the appropriate content according to the question that the query that the user is. Why we need to do that in this case? Because, as you probably know, HTTP is a protocol, a stateless protocol. And then we are going to use, in this case, HTTPS, and we will take control of the session of the user in order to send the appropriate information according to this way we will create a connection end to end, and then on this connection it will be established from beginning to end in between one user and the server, and then this way we will be ensuring that the information that we send back to the user is the correct one. If you don't do that, you can mess up the information or even not working at all, because you have multiple users asking to the service multiple things, multiple questions, multiple queries. You don't have control of the a user session. Is gonna be impossible to correctly send back or send the answer from the model to the correct user. So this is important in this scenario where we had a application server. You know, the application server, as you know, is done with a string lead, and we will use basically for everything here Python. Okay, with this you have everything you need. It's just creating these two files. That's the minimum if you want to say that, the minimum that you need to create and deploy the app service APP engine, sorry. And then on the next step is you just execute gcloud app deploy. And then it gives you some parameters. Is what it's going to do. I'm going to use app.yaml. This is the repo. This is the project. The target service is default. So you can specify here many things. This is just we do it by default. You can set up here the service. The version is taking by the next one. I had already 5 or 6 versions on the. I will show you now. This is going to be the URL where it will be serving the application, and this is the service account I will use to set up the service in APP Engine. And that's all. No, you can change all these all these parameters, but we leave it by default for now. You can play around later once you read the documentation. So now it's starting the deploy. It will take us some minutes. So now you see you're pulling the image from the Google Container Registry, creating a Docker. It basically is creating a Docker which is going to be served in the APP engine. It will install the requirements, etc., etc. This is exactly the same that create a Docker in local, but this Docker later on will run in R. You see here we are installing Python. Here is here. It install requirements. You can see here how we're installing the requirements, installing all the libraries, etc. Now it's installed all the packages. You see here, all the packages are installed, and now it took 26 seconds, and now we'll start the final copy and deploy of the service to Jasaki exporting. We already had the Docker practically finished it. Yeah, runtime Python, and now we will see. Yeah, exactly. One second, and then let me show you something in the meantime. You go here to services, you had the versions of the service. Now we have this online, and now we are creating this one, the latest one. Yeah, we don't have instances here, but there is multiple things that you can do. You can also create cron for services, activate some firewall rules just in case that you are deploying some specific application which is listening on a specific port, for example Olama. Could be a case that you want to access, you want to deploy Olama in one of these. I don't know if it even how to say suite one of the templates of the APP engine for that. But well, you manage everything from here. You can keep a track of the, you see here 5 million ops. So you had a lot of yeah, the service is not expensive at all. Last 15 hours, all the tests I'm doing is zero cost, practically. And let's check how it goes. Yeah, here now it's going to take some minutes, approximately 7 minutes after this is done. I'm going to stop and later on we will do the final test. Okay, this is done. It's finished. It. Now you can review with gcloud app log tiles as default. You can, one second, let me copy the logs. In case that there is a failure or a problem, you can simply, vaya. Now it doesn't want. Yeah. You can take a look. If there is something interesting, but yeah, it's basically in case that you want to review the logs or simply execute browse, gcloud app browse, and this will open exactly your application. As you can see here, this is the URL that the when you used to deploy the service proposed. This can be changed. It had to have a format. I can post you later on the document. No one is here. No, it's not here. Well, there is not only one file. There is multiple files with that you can define for the service depending on the or the language or the technology you are gonna use. It will be more or other files. If you go to go, for example, it can be some others. Yeah, depending on what you choose. Also, it's the custom. Not every file apply to every configuration. Okay, and now, well, you watched the video I upload yesterday, how to create this multimodal prompt. Is the same. Let me check. This is not. I think I have it here in Vertex AI data car. Yeah, it's only two files. I just to make a test. It's two files for a car I had some time ago in Switzerland. Yeah, this was the video. It's exactly the same test I did. It's an invoice. They are in German, and then I asked the. Oops. What happened here? Let me 1 second. I didn't know. I had just to refresh the page and well, the files are uploaded, the wheels file and the payment to the Straßenverkehrsamt. And now, well, this is exactly the same that I say. It's just extracting. You see here the instructions. I see in the chatbot to Gemini. This is my initial question. It's hard coded for now. Later on, I will make this a little bit more flexible. And from now on, you can, after the first prompt, you can start now to interact with the bot. Here, I'm just asking, well, extract the key facts of the documents, the date of the documents, don't show the names, just say Mr. X or Mrs. X, extract the postal address. If the language is not English, respond in English together with the document language. Well, just some silly prompt, just the documents as you remember, they are in German. So even this document is quite difficult to read. This as well, not very precise. This is just prompt Felgenrader, this approval brief. Okay. Yes, is this only the something regarding the wheels of the car that they were checked? But I'm just asking to extract the information. Yeah. Tire size, additional information. So you have three documents, German. This is an invoice. This is a confirmation the receipt of the tires of wires for the car and German. Now we can make some other questions like which organizations issued the documents. I have it here. You can interact with the model. Now it is going to see here running. The model is interacting with the Vertex AI with Gemini Pro. And then it's okay, document 1, Straßenverkehrsamt, der Kanton Zurich. Exactly, this document is a Mackrentyre Horgen, this is a garage, a place where you repair the car in Switzerland. It's in a specific organization. Yeah, it's the registration document, this that one, this is the car registration ID. Usually, well, every country has something different. And now I'm going to ask as well to extract some other information, like the number, the car number. And you will see that also, well, this again is probably pretty basic. It's set H22844. Exactly. As mentioned in document 3. And that's all. It's, as you see, very easy. There is many options. I give you here on the code different links you can review at your convenience with the at least the most relevant information. Yeah, the topic is complex if you want to master it, but with this you have at least an idea how to start. We are working with state-of-the-art technologies, probably some of the latest ones, and well, is very quickly. We create a chatbot. We are interacting with one of the latest models, multimodal model. We create a conversational chatbot, and we deploy the application, and now it's ready to use. Obviously, there is a lot of things to do. Up to this can be probably a service that is working for thousands of users. Well, probably we need to control much more, including, for example, a vector database to provide some additional context to the model. We will need to include as well security in order to authenticate correctly the users, etc. Well, there is many things. It's just a beginning, but I think that it can be very useful if you are doing some development or you plan to deploy something in Google Cloud. You have here a starting point for that. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching the video, and as I say usually, if you like it, give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, share with your friends the content, and share as well, or promote the channel, with your friends, just to get a little bit more visibility on YouTube. Thank you very much. See you soon.